Good afternoon, Chef Wall here. Do you like Alaskan king crab eat Benedict, brunch-sized liquor, and use your strong hand whilst doing it? Well, stick around, because they're all coming together, you in a big, fancy group.
Brunch with Chef Hall. Episode 3, The Alaskan King Crab Aches Benedict. The following program contains nudity, violence, coarse language, taking of illicit substances, dangerous stunts, and etc. No animals were harmed during the making of this program. Viewer discretion is strongly advised. As always, please brunch irresponsibly.
First feature of the day, not that it's alcoholic, Aquafina. This vessel, it's going to be important later on in this video. We're just going to take this, get hydrated off the bat. Oh yeah, the mundane mediocrity of that water is just amazing. All right, before we do anything here, we're going to introduce the first feature of the day. We're going to get some mimosas rolling here, all right? Prosecco, vintage of 1877. Little fun fact about 1877. Chester Greenwood actually invented earmuffs at the tender age of 15. So if you ever had cold ears, throw the earmuffs off, thank Chester, okay? Other part, delicious, completely pressed orange juice from independent grocers in Whitehorse, Yukon. Just wanna slide it in there. Later on, this might get a little sloppy and a little bubbly, but you know, you just gotta do what you can with what you got. The orange juice in there. Just pound it down. We're not gonna do that this one. We're just gonna sip it. Pace ourselves. We got a lot of tactical cooking here to do, so we wanna stay a little bit more in the zone to make that happen.
All right, so with our ingredients today, we're actually gonna use a ciabatta Asiago jalapeno bread rather than an English muffin. This is gonna be a little bit of our base here. We're gonna load it up with a gentle spread of fig jam just to give it a little sweet with the savory type of stuff and the garlic flavored hollandaise sauce that we're gonna end up employing here. We're gonna throw a little bit of this avocado slightly down on top of the fig spread, put our crab on top, hollandaise sauce. If anyone knows anything about hollandaise sauce, it's basically just straight butter and eggs. So that's what we're gonna show you how to do. And then garnish it with some parsley and some tomatoes with a little bit of fresh fruit on the side. All right, so we just wanna get this water underneath this bowl to a slight simmer for our hollandaise sauce. I'm gonna turn up a medium and continue on. We're just gonna take this pre-prepared crab meat and garlic butter and we're just gonna load it back onto the pan here, preheat it, kind of give it a little bit of a slow fry here.
Cooler ways to do this, just using the eggshell to just separate the egg yolks that you're gonna need to put in your hollandaise sauce. But we're sponsored by the ever mediocre Aquafina here, so we're gonna give them a little bit of love. So here comes that. Here's the important vessel. You can use anything for this. It doesn't have to be Aquafina. And all of our sponsors would say that, you know, you should buy it, but just, So as you can see, Aquafina product placement for our sponsor. Yeah, it doesn't really work that good. It's kind of mediocre, just like Aquafina. Tried and true method here. Crack the egg about halfway down. Get it on the first try here. I'm gonna split that apart. And we're gonna go back and forth into a plate that we've kind of laid aside here. So we get all most of that out of there. And then we're gonna dump her into our other yolks.
So we're gonna add this butter. Start getting it melted for the hollandaise sauce.
Get out the old trusty yellow lemon squeezing device here and get some freshly squeezed juice. In the spirit of freshly squeezed orange juice mimosas right into those egg yolks. And we'll move on.
Then we're just gonna load up the bada bread here into the toaster for light warming.
We're just gonna poach these eggs. Load them right up. Now if you don't fuck that up, chances are you're gonna have a pretty good breakfast here, but the most technical part of this dish is about to come right up, so stay tuned. Here's our second feature. And for our second feature of the day, we have Yukon Gold from Yukon Brewing, a local favorite. There's a poem on here by a Canadian poet, Robert Service. I'm gonna read a little verse to you. There are strange things done in the midnight sun by men who moil for gold. The Arctic trails have their secret tales that would make your blood run cold. The Northern Lights have seen queer sight, but the queerest sight they ever did see was a night on the marge by Lake LaBarge I cremated Sam McGee. Jeff Hall here. Don't forget to follow and subscribe if you like the content. The spirit of Johnny Cash. Got the shades on, you know, cover your eyes, protect your eyes from what's about to happen here. That's not a winner. Not gonna lie, we have our first loser of brunch series. This beer tastes like an old shirt that has soaked in liquor for 3 days at a music festival by some fucking just out of control fucking degenerate partier. And you just like slop that up off that shirt. Not good. Not a winner.
All right, so we're gonna drop the egg yolks and the lemon with a little bit of salt. All right, so we're gonna whisk this vigorously, and our strong hand here is gonna really come in handy because you really don't want this to poach and ruin your hollandaise sauce. It can turn out real bad if you don't do it properly. But as you're whisking vigorously, you wanna just pour in the butter ever so slowly. Like I said, a strong hand really helps out here. And voila, there we have it.
All right, for our third feature of the day, we have from Winterlawn Brewing, Pingo Pale Ale. Tangerine, crisp, and easy. This beer is delicious. We already had a pre-game one of this. The little muskox buffalo guy here on the front, although it was a very nice little image there, it's a little bit misleading to the word pingo, because a pingo is actually an interpermafrost ice-covered hill, ranging in height from 3 to 70 to 30 to 1,000 meters in diameter. They're typically conical in shape and grow and persist in only permafrost environments. Pingo, baby. That is delicious. Wow. Pingo. Pale ale. Winterlawn Brewing.
That lightly toasted ciabatta. So we're going to want to just put a light spread of fig jam on here. And you know what? I'm going to have to ask my friend, Mini Strong Hand, to come in and help get a nice even spread. Don't be afraid to ask for help, you know, in your day-to-day life. You have friends out there that are willing to, and you know, maybe they have a smaller hand than you, but you know, it's all about the community and the people involved. And we'll just start to load up with a little bit of avocado. And now we finish placing the avocado. We'll just take the crab meat and we'll just gently place it on top of the avocado. The crab, we'll place our poached eggs. Now for the most important stuff.
I've heard people say that too much of anything is not good for you. But I don't know about that. As many times as we've loved, we've shared love and made love, it doesn't seem to me like it's enough. It's just not enough.
Now for a little garnish of parsley. Now for a little cracked pepper. Delicious. And there we have it, ladies and gentlemen. Bon appetit.